Hi and welcome to this video by TechyV.com, your solution provider. I'm Frank and I'll show you how to download and install VMware Workstation 8. With VMware Workstation, you can create and run securely multiple operating systems with high performance. VMware Workstation is cross-platform based, supports both 64 and 32-bit machines. With it, you can pause your running virtual machines and switch to other heavy tasks in your PC to balance your performance and speed. AS Auto product feature helps to reduce crash from bugs, viruses, or other malware attacks. You can share your optical drives, physical networks, and printers, etc. without any extra driver configuration. It also allows you to run 3D graphics. So let's check this out. To download it, open your web browser and go to www.google.com, then in the search box type VMware Workstation and press enter to search. Okay, then click on this link, download VMware Workstation, that is from www.vmware.com, which is the original website. You can see the listing of all VMware products and you have to choose it from this category, that is desktop and end user computing VMware Workstation. Click on this link to go to the download page. From here you can choose your version. Since I'm showing you this installation in a Windows operating system, so I'm clicking on this link. Okay, to download it you need to be a registered user of VMware. If you are already a user, then log in directly to your account. If you're a new user, then click on register and you have to fill up a form, then confirm it, then you'll be directed to the download link. And since I already have the setup file, so I'm taking you directly to the installation process. Now double click on the exe file to launch it. Click run to allow this security check. Self-extraction has been started, so please wait and let that. This is the introduction to your VMware Workstation. Click next. If you click typical, if you will install according to the default settings. If you want to view or change this, click custom. Click to check to select or deselect any of these checkboxes. This will be a destination folder. If you want to change it, then you can browse directly from here. Then click next. Okay. This will be your default folder to store your virtual machine files. If you want to change it, then you can browse it from here. You can also configure it when you're using VMware Workstation. Click next. This is the auto update feature. If you do not want this, then click to uncheck it. Click next. Okay, this is the user experience improvement program. That is, your system data and user statistics will be sent to VMware server, especially bug and error reports. This will help to improve their further developments. If you do not want this, then you can click on it to uncheck this box. These are the shortcuts to be installed. Then click next. Okay, then click continue to begin your installation process. You'll be asked to insert a license key. Since I'm showing you a trial installation, so I'm clicking skip to this. Okay, now you have to click on restart now to complete the installation process. All right, welcome back. Installation has been complete. You'll also find a quick launch shortcut, so all you have to do is double click on it to run your VMware Workstation. This is your license agreement. Click select yes and click OK to agree with the license agreement. Alright, welcome to your VMware Workstation interface. This is your library. You can find your quick links to your last used virtual machines or your own created machines. You can create new machines by clicking on this link. You can open your virtual machine files by clicking on this link. You can edit this application by clicking on Workstation Preferences. You'll find many articles regarding how to use VMware Workstation and configure it. So you can browse your articles from here. So thanks for watching it and check out for more videos from TechyV.com.